Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna.
Adi Gadadhar Prabhu is there?
Yes, Mataji, I am here. Hare Krishna, okay. Dandavat Pranam.
Dandavat Pranam, Prabhu. Thank you so much for your association. And thank you, everyone, for joining us, introducing themselves and chanting so wonderfully. So we'll move on to the next part of the program, which is the class by His Grace, Adi Gadadhar Prabhu. And he will continue with our Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela. So Prabhuji, thank you so much for your wonderful association. And now you can please take over the call. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Mataji. Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Advaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Advaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Advaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. We are continuing our study of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela, chapter number 21st, verse number 116. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Lord Krishna Himself, 500 years ago, He gave these transcendental instruction and verses filled with deep spiritual knowledge to Srila Sanatan Goswami. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is describing the opulent sweetness and glories of Sri Krishna. So it is Krishna in the mood of His own devotee who is telling us His own glories. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking. So we'll discuss several verses today, I think five or six, and they are written down so poetically by Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Maharaj that what I think we will do is we will first read all the verses and then we'll read all the translation and one purport. We'll continue reading the verses until we come to a purport. So verse number 116.
Tate Sakshi Sei Rama Narayaner Priyatama Pati Vrata Ganera Upasya Tino Ye Madhurya Lobhe Chhadi Sab Kama Bhoge Vrata Kori Kori La Tapasya.
Verse number 117.
Seita Madhurya Sara Anya Siddhi Nahi Tara Tinho Madhurya Di Guna Khani Ara Sab Prakashe Tandra Datta Guna Bhase Yaha Yata Prakashe Karya Jani Gopi Bhava Darapana Nava Nava Kshane Kshana Tara Age Krishnera Madhurya Donhe Kare Huda Hudi Bade Mukha Nahi Mudi Nava Nava Donhara Prachurya Karma Tapa Yoga Jnana Vidhi Bhakti Japa Dhyana Iha haite madhurya durlabha Kevala ye rag marge Bhaje krishne anurage Tare krishna madhurya sulabha Sei rupa vrajashraya Aishwarya madhurya maya దివ్య గుణ గణ రత్నాలయ ఆనేర వైభవ సత్తా కృష్ణ దత్తా భగవతా కృష్ణ సర్వ అంశీ సర్వాశ్రయ శ్రీ లజ్జా దయా కీర్తి ధైర్య వైశారదీమతి ఏ సబ కృష్ణే ప్రతిష్ఠిత సుశీల మృదు వాదన్య కృష్ణ సమ నాహి అన్య కృష్ణ కోరే జగతే రాహిత. సో బ్యూటిఫుల్ కృష్ణదాస్ కవిరాజ్ గోస్వామి ఇస్ అన్పారలల్డ్. జస్ ఫీల్ లైక్ జస్ కంటిన్యూయింగ్ టు రీడ్. సో ట్రాన్స్లేషన్ ఆఫ్ వర్స్ నంబర్ 116. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is describing the glories of Krishna and Goloka Vrindavan. The vivid evidence in this regard is that the dearest consort of Narayan, the goddess of fortune, who is worshipped by all chaste women, gave up everything in her desire to enjoy Krishna. Being captivated by his unparalleled sweetness, thus she took a great vow and underwent severe austerities. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is explaining that although Srimati Lakshmi Devi, who is also known as Rama, she is Lord Narayan's Priyatama. Tate Sakshi Sei Rama Narayaner Priyatama Pativrata Ganera Upasya. Anybody who is Pativrata, anybody who is very chaste, she is their worshipable goddess. Pativrata Ganera Upasya. She is their worshipable goddess, but she, tenho ye madhurya lobhe, out of a transcendental lobe, greed for madhurya ras, chhadi shab kama bhoge, having intense desire to reciprocate with Krishna, to enjoy with Krishna, vrata kori kari la tapasya. She performed vrat tapasya to associate with Krishna. This is the sweetness of Krishna. We'll chant our Mangala Charan and then start discussing each of the verses that we read. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmay Shri Gurave Namaha శ్రీ చైతన్య మనోభీష్టం స్థాపితం యేన భూతలే స్వయం రూప కదా మహ్యం దదాతి స్వపదాంతికం వందేహం శ్రీ గురు శ్రీయుత పదకమలం శ్రీ గురున్ వైష్ణవాంశ్చ శ్రీ రూపం సాగ్రజాతాం సహగణ రఘునాథాన్వితం తం సజీవం సాద్వైతం సావదూతం పరిజనా సహితం కృష్ణ చైతన్య దేవం శ్రీ రాధా కృష్ణ పదాం సహగణ లలిత శ్రీ విశాఖాన్వితాంశ్చ నమ ఓం విష్ణుపాదాయ కృష్ణ ప్రేష్టాయ భూతలే శ్రీమతే భక్తి వేదాంత స్వామిన్ ఇతి నామినే నమస్తే సారస్వతే దేవే గౌరవాణీ ప్రచారిణే నిర్విశేష శూన్యవాది పాశ్చాత్య దేశ తారిణే వాంఛా కల్పతరుభ్యశ్చ కృపా సింధుభ్య ఏవ చ పతీతానాం పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమో నమః. नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरात्विते नमः। पञ्चतत्त्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचना गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्ण। I would like to offer my humble obeisances at the lotus feet of all the devotees who are listening. And I would also like to beg at the lotus feet of each one of you to please shower your blessings and good wishes upon me so that I may be able to serve you in such a way that all our hearts become purified and become attracted to the beautiful, effulgent, all-merciful lotus feet of Shri Guru and Shri Gauranga. Hare Krishna. So we are reading this very, very beautiful verses from Chaitanya Charitamrita. These are actually very, very esoteric, very difficult to understand topics, because here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is disclosing spiritual truths which are practically unknown to us human beings. The traditional understanding is that Lord Narayan or Lord Vishnu in Vaikuntha is supreme, or some spiritualists consider the Brahma Jyoti, the Brahman, impersonal Brahman, to be the highest realization on the spiritual path. But here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the highest authority, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Matamidam Tatradara na para. There is nothing superior to the opinion given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's opinion is most important, is the last word. And Mahaprabhu is saying that Lord Narayan or Lord Vishnu are not supreme. The demigods like Shivji, Brahmaji, they are not supreme. So many Brahmajis, so many Shivjis came to have darshan of Lord Krishna in Dwaraka. And our Brahmaji, four-headed Brahmaji, personally saw it. So many Shivjis, so many Brahmajis were offering dandavats with their helmets at the lotus feet of Dwarkadish Krishna. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is explaining that the demigods are not supreme. The Brahma Jyoti is subservient to Krishna. Brahmano hi pratishta aham, aham adir hi devanam. I am the source of all the demigods. And even Lord Narayan, hankers for the darshan of Lord Krishna. Because Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the last word in transcendence. Mataha parataram na anyat kinchid asti dhananjaya. Mayi sarvam itam protam sutre mani gana eva. Everything rests on Krishna. Krishna is the highest. Ishvara parama Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is explaining Krishna Tattva. We should all understand this very clearly. Krishna is everything. Pita aham asya jagata, mata dhata pitamaha, vedyam pavitram omkara, rig sama yajur evacha. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, I am father, I am your mother, I am your grandfather. I am the sacred syllable, om. I am Rig, Sam, Yajur, Vedas. Everything is Krishna. Everything is coming from Krishna. Our Gopinath, Krishna, in his original two-handed form, who is Muralidhar, our Venu Gopal, who dances with his topmost devotees, the gopis, Gopi Jana Vallabh, dances in the forests, the different forests of Vrindavan, which manifest different seasons of Vrindavan. Vrindavan Chandra, Vrindavan Bihari, Kunja Bihari, who performs Rasa Leela with his gopis. Ras Vihari Krishna. He is the Supreme. Even Narayan wants to have darshan of Krishna. That is why he stole the newborn children of the Brahman who lived in Dwarka. Krishna has four qualities which no one has. Jivera Swarup Hoye Krishnera Nityadas. We are Jivatmas. And Jivatmas in their perfected stage have 50 qualities fully manifested. A living entity, when he becomes perfect at the highest stage of evolution within the material world, the living entity can become, go up to the level of not just any demigod or demon, but the living entity can go up to the level of Brahmaji. Brahmaji has these 50 qualities fully manifested. And beyond Brahmaji is Lord Shiva, Shankar Bhagwan. He has 55 qualities fully manifested. But greater than Shankar Bhagwan is Vishnu Bhagwan, Narayan Bhagwan. He manifests 60 qualities in full. Shivaji chooses to manifest only 55. Brahmaji can manifest only 50. Shivaji chooses to manifest only 55. Lord Vishnu chooses to manifest only 60. But the Purna Purushottam Bhagwan is Shri Krishna. Vrindavan Chandra Krishna. Gopinath. He manifests all the 64 qualities enumerated by Srila Rupa Goswami. All these 64 qualities are there in Krishna. The four surplus qualities which Krishna manifests, which are not manifested by any other avatar of Krishna, like Lord Narayan or Lord Ramchandra or Lord Narasimha Bhagwan, are Rupa Madhuri, वेणु माधुरी, लीला माधुरी एंड प्रेम माधुरी. दीज आर द फोर क्वालिटीज, 61st, 62nd, 63rd एंड 64th क्वालिटी ऑफ कृष्ण, विच आर एक्सक्लूसिव फॉर कृष्ण. रूप माधुरी, कृष्णास फॉर्म इज सो अनबिलीवेबली, सो इनकम्पेरेबली, सो ट्रांसेंडेंटली ब्यूटिफुल दैट वी कैनॉट इवन इमेजिन इट. देर आर सर्टन थिंग्स विच वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड, certain things we can understand. How to put the credit card in the ATM machine, or how to put the debit card in the ATM machine and withdraw money, we can understand. But exactly how the magnetic strip is read, deciphered, how the signal is going, how the dollar bills are being counted, how they are pushed out, everything technically, which wire goes where, how much electricity is used in one transaction, all those exact intricate details we cannot understand, but we can imagine something must be going on. You know, some amount of electricity must be used, there must be some money counting machine, somebody must have put cash already inside, somebody has created the software for this, somebody has created the hardware for this, somebody has done the robotics for this machine. We can imagine. I can. I don't understand exactly, but I can imagine how this must be happening. I have some inkling how it must be happening. So there is understanding. Beyond the understanding, things that we cannot understand, we can imagine. But Krishna is so beautiful that we cannot even imagine. We cannot even imagine how beautiful Krishna is, because we have no experience of anything like that, anything even close. We have, with our eyes, only seen material beauty. But how do we appreciate the spiritual form? Krishna's form is spiritual. It's a completely different dimension. Completely different dimension. It is like a cactus plant growing in the middle of the Sahara Desert in Africa, trying to understand the beautiful coral reef that grows under the ocean off the coast of Australia, the Barrier Reef. How can a cactus plant understand what is the beautiful, colorful coral that grows under the sea, under the ocean? Completely two different worlds. But for us to understand Krishna is even more difficult. What to understand Krishna? Even to go to Krishna's abode is impossible for us. Our acharyas explain that it is easier to thread a full-grown camel through the eye of a tiny needle than for a living entity to go back to the spiritual world. How can we put a camel, living camel, through the eye of a tiny needle? The eye must be hardly 1 millimeter in length, and even less than 1 millimeter in width. How can we pass a camel who is so many feet tall, so many feet wide. How can we put that camel through the eye of a needle alive? It's impossible. But our acharyas explain it is even more impossible for a living entity to return back to the spiritual world. That is how difficult it is. But this is exactly the purpose of Krishna consciousness. Just imagine. Why is it so difficult for us to go back to the spiritual world? Because we just cannot do it on our own. Our efforts, our endeavors are not enough, no matter how hard we try. We need Krishna's merciful intervention. The two fingers of Damodar Leela. Our efforts and Krishna's mercy. No matter how hard we try, unless there is Krishna's mercy, we cannot go back to Godhead. And that is exactly what Prabhupada writes on his Jaladuta Bhajan. Krishna Tava Punya Habe Bhai. Actually, right now, Prabhupada is on Jaladuta because he left India on the Jaladuta ship on Sunday, more than 50 years ago, in 1965. But historically, according to the calendar, right now he is traveling in the Bay of Bengal. And then he's going to go to Sri Lanka, Ceylon. And from there he's going to come to Cochin. And then there will be Janmashtami on the ship. And then his trunks loaded with his Srimad Bhagavatam will be placed on the Jaladuta. And then his journey will continue through the Arabian Sea. He will go across the canal, Suez Canal, and then enter into the Atlantic Ocean, and then come to Boston, Massachusetts, and then come down to New York. Almost 40 days of voyage on a ship for someone who turned 70 years old. On the ship, celebrated his 70th birthday on the ship. For a 70-year-old man with no one to help, he was not eating the food that was cooked by the crew on the cargo ship. He was making his own khichdi and puris. He explains in his beautiful bhajan that he writes on Jaladuta this principle. How can we go back to Godhead? Krishna tave punya have bhai. But before that, let us finish reading beautiful translations by Srila Prabhupada of these verses that we read. So first is Rupa Madhuri, Krishna's physical beauty. It's astounding, incomparable beauty. Venu Madhuri, what Krishna can do through his flute. Krishna's divine love pours out from the flute and enters the hearts of the devotees through their ears. Through Krishna's flute, he can give transcendental knowledge to Brahma. Tene Brahma Ridaye Adi Kavaye, the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna's flute is simply wonderful, like Prabhupada used to say. Simply wonderful. Krishna's Rupa Madhuri, the sweetness of his physical beauty, is simply wonderful. Venu Madhuri, the sweetness of his flute, is simply wonderful. Leela Madhuri, the amazing pastimes that Krishna performs in Golok Vrindavan are unparalleled. Where do you see the Supreme Personality of Godhead dancing in the middle of the night on a beautiful full moon night in the enchanting forest of grace, forest of Vrindavan, with millions and millions and millions of Lakshmis. Lakshmi Sahasrashata Sambrama Sevyamanam Govindam Adipurusham Tam Aham Bhajami. Where can you see this? Krishna's Leela, where can you see the Supreme Bhagavan stealing butter, stealing clothes? And the gopis stealing his flute. What kind of leelas are these? Radharani sometimes steals Krishna's flute. She steals Krishna's heart. Vraje prasiddham navanita choram Gopanganam Chadukula Choram Aneka Janmar Jita Papa Choram Chaura Graganyam Purusham Namami Shri Radhikaya Ridayasya Choram Navam Budashamalakanti Choram Padashritanam Chasamasta Choram Choragraganyam Purusham Namami. Krishna's Leelas are simply wonderful. And finally, so we discussed Rupa Madhuri, his beauty, physical beauty. We discussed Venu Madhuri, the sweetness of his flute. We discussed Leela Madhuri, his inconceivable activities like stealing butter, Rasa Leela. Which other incarnation performs Rasa Leela? What kind of Rasleela is it? In this Rasleela, there is such unity in diversity. There are the gopis who are personal expansions of Srimati Radharani, who descended from Goloka Vrindavan in this Rasleela. There were sadhana siddha gopis, devotees who had done intense sadhana to engage with Krishna in Parakya Madhurya Bhav, Madhurya Ras. There were Sadhana Siddha Gopis. There were the Dandakaranya Gopis, the Rishis of Dandakaranya, who in Treta Yuga had seen the beautiful form of Shri Shri Sita Ramchandra. And seeing their beauty, they wanted to become the maid servants of Srimati Sita Devi, and they wanted to become part of the Madhurya Leela of the Supreme Lord. But Sri Ram told them in their heart, heart to heart, that wait, I cannot do this. I am Maryada Purushottam, I am Ek Patni Vrata. But in the next Yuga, I will come as Gopi Janavallabh. And all of you male rishis, until then, from Treta Yuga to Dwapar Yuga, thousands of years, in this forest of Dandakaranya, you will have to continue with your sadhana. You will have to continue with your bhajan until you attain perfection, siddhi. Then you will give up your body in this forest of Dandakaranya. And you will be born in the forest of Vrinda Devi. Vrindavan. And you will be born as gopis. And then I will fulfill your desires. I will accept all of you. So all these hundreds of rishis, very enthusiastically, with great determination, they continued their bhajan for thousands of years, waiting for Treta Yuga to end. Then Dwapar Yuga started. Dwapar Yuga is more than 800,000 years. They waited for more than 800,000 years for the end of Dwapar Yuga to come. And towards the very end of Dwapar Yuga, their beloved Lord came as Gopinath. Just see how much patience is required for success. Shortcuts will lead us to a big house, a big fat bank balance, lot of fame, lot of claps from people in this world. But it will all be finished. It will all be finished. Or it may take us to the heavenly planets, where it will last for a few additional years, but then it will be finished. Ah, Brahma Bhuvana Loka Punar Avarti No Arjuna Mam Upetya Tukaunteya Punar Janma Navidyate. But if we invest in Krishna, then we will be able to follow in the footsteps of the sadhana siddha gopis. And the Shrutis also wanted to associate with the personal form of Krishna. So there were Shruta gopis, all the 108 Upanishads and other supplementary Upanishads. All the Shrutis, they all came as gopis, personified as gopis. They were part of the Rasa Leela. Then there were the beautiful residents of Ayodhya Dham. When Lord Ramchandra was in Ayodhya, as Ayodhya Pati, and Srimati Sita Devi was Ayodhya Rani, the young damsels, the young girls of Ayodhya Dham would every day have darshan of Sri Ramchandra, because Lord Ram would give darshan every day. And when they would see Sri Sri Sita Ram, they also wanted to become part of the Madhurya Rasa. From Dasya Ras, they wanted to go to Madhurya Ras. They wanted a promotion. And again, Lord Ramchandra, being so merciful, he fulfilled that desire. And these Ayodhyavasi Vadhus, they were born also as Vraja Vadhus. In this way, there were many, many, many different types of gopis. But they are all serving Krishna in Rasa Leela, giving Krishna happiness. And in return, Krishna, who is Anandambudhi, who is an ocean of Ananda, Satchid Ananda Vigraha, Anandamayi Vigraha, he gives Ananda to his devotees in exchange. He gives more Ananda than what the devotee can give him. That is a spiritual transcendental competition. And the devotee says, you are giving me so much spiritual bliss, Krishna. Let me do a little bit more for you. I am not doing enough for you. And then Krishna gives even more. even more bliss. And the devotee feels, I am not able to reciprocate enough with you, Krishna. You are doing so much for me. And what have I done? Nothing. Therefore, a devotee becomes humble. This is the secret to humility. When we learn to appreciate what Krishna and Krishna's devotees have done for us, and we honestly analyze our heart, we search through our heart, we realize that, oh, I am such a failure, I have not done anything. And naturally we get humility. Naturally we get humility. This must be the attitude of Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami Maharaj, who has given us Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. How else can you think that you are lower than a worm in the stool? How else can you think that anyone who chants my name will lose all his or her pious credits? It must be some form of internal ecstasy, internal ecstatic thinking that must be going on in their sweethearts, madhurya-filled hearts, that they can feel like that, feel such humility, although they are so exalted. So this is prema madhuri. The fourth, Krishna's devotees love him so much. You will not find such devotees anywhere. The quality of devotees that Krishna has, no other incarnation has. And this we have discussed already from Brihad Bhagavatamrita. How Narad Muni was searching for the greatest recipient of Krishna's mercy. And he goes all the way from that South Indian Brahmin to the king of Sri Rangam, to Indradev, to Brahmaji, to Parvati, to Shivji, to Lakshmiji, to Prahlad Maharaj, to Hanumanji, to Pandavas, to Dwarkavasis, to Uddhavji, and finally Uddhav says, I am not the best devotee. The best devotees are the gopis who are willing to give a moment of relief to Krishna from his headache, and in return they are not willing, they are ecstatically eager, desperate to go to hell for eternity. Therefore the gopis are the highest. Krishna's friends, Lota Baba, it's been 5,000 years, still he's standing there holding Lota, waiting for Krishna to come back to Vrindavan and accept lunch at his home, at Puchari, the tail of Giriraj, still waiting there. Where can you find such devotees? Even Lakshmiji wanted to become one such devotee. That is why she did Vrata and came down. be born as a gopi in Vrindavan. The next verse, verse number 117, a translation, Srila Prabhupada writes, the quintessence of Krishna's sweet bodily lustre is so perfect that there is no perfection above it. Seita madhurya sara anya siddhi nahi tara. It is the immutable mind of all transcendental qualities. Krishna's bodily lustre. In his other manifestations and personal expansions, there is only a partial exhibition of such qualities. We understand all his personal expansions in this way. So Krishna is like the full moon of Sharad Purnima. And all other incarnations are also moons, but they are not full moons. They are 90% moons, 80% moons, 70% moons, like that. The moon is moon on every day, whether it is Amavasya or Purnima. The moon is always full, but we cannot see the full moon. The moon chooses to reveal a certain aspect of his to us. Similarly, Lord Ramchandra chooses to reveal only certain potencies. Lord Narasimha Dev chooses to reveal only certain potencies. It doesn't mean that Lord Narasimha Dev is less than Lord Krishna or different than Lord Krishna. No. When Krishna comes as Narasimha Dev, he chooses to manifest only certain potencies and chooses not to manifest certain potencies. Same with Lord Ramchandra. Chooses not to manifest certain potencies. But when he comes as Krishna Chandra, he is the full moon, Purnima. He shows everything. He shows full opulences. That is why attachment to Krishna is the perfection of bhakti. Verse number 118. Both the gopis and Krishna are complete. The gopis' ecstatic love is like a mirror that becomes newer and newer at every moment and reflects Krishna's bodily lustre and sweetness. Thus competition increases. Since neither give up, their pastimes become newer and newer, and both sides constantly increases. This is the mood of Holi also. When we see Holi in the material world, it is so unholy, so to say. They throw paint and chemicals at each other and it's all very harsh, very ugra. They drink bhang and intoxicants and they play materialistic music. It's just a perverted reflection of the original Holi that takes place in the spiritual world. In the original Holi, Srimati Radharani is given beautiful colors by the manjaris and the gopis. These colors are made from natural ingredients like fruits, fruit juices, different colored flowers, their crushed powder, like that. They are fragrant. They are delicious. They are natural. They are pleasing. Patram pushpam phalam toyam. And Srimati Radharani applies color very artistically on Krishna's beautiful face. And she thinks, my dear Ghanashyam, you're looking so beautiful now. And then Krishna takes color and puts it on Radharani and says, my dear Radhika, you are looking so beautiful with these colors. These colors are serving your beauty and enhancing your beauty. And Radharani says, no, I am not beautiful. You are more beautiful. Here, I will put more color on you and I will make you even more beautiful. My Prananath. And then Krishna becomes more beautiful. And then he reciprocates by putting more color on Srimati Radharani. And says, look. Now you are so much more beautiful. These colors are serving you so sweetly to enhance your beauty. And Srimati Radharani says, no, 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 no. I am not beautiful. I will make you even more beautiful. And she puts more color on Krishna. And in this way, there is a competition. There is a competition. And Srimati Radharani makes the gopis and their assistants, the manjaris, also to participate. And everybody is engaged in giving each other more and more spiritual joy. Not that I am more beautiful than you, or I will throw more color. No. With this color, I will make you look more beautiful. I will enhance your beauty. And Krishna says, I will enhance your beauty. That is spiritual competition. That is transcendental competition. This is the competition that Srila Prabhupada wanted to see among his followers. That we are competing to inspire each other more and more. That is spiritual world. Verse number 119. The transcendental mellows generated from the dealings between the gopis and Krishna cannot be tasted by means of fruitive activity, yogic austerities, speculative knowledge, regulative devotional service, mantra yoga, or meditation. So many things. We should pay attention. I'll read this again. The transcendental mellows generated from dealings between the gopis and Krishna cannot be tasted. Which means, gopi bhav cannot be tasted by us through karmakand, through austerities, means fasting, tapasharya, speculative knowledge, by studying different scriptures, different tikas of different authors. Regulative devotional service means Vaidhi Bhakti. Mantra yoga, by chanting mantra, or by meditation. Karma, tapa, yoga, jnana, vidhi, bhakti, japa, dhyana, iha haite madhurya durlabha, kevala ye raga marge, bhaje krishna anurage, tare krishna madhurya sulabha, kevala ye raga marge. This sweetness can be tasted only through the spontaneous love of liberated persons who chant the holy names with great ecstatic love. Let us read this sentence 3 times. Let us tattoo this sentence into our consciousness. Let this sentence, spoken by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, written down by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Maharaj, and translated into English language by our most merciful Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada, be the take-home message of today's class. This sweetness, which sweetness? The sweetness of Vraja Bhakti. This sweetness can be tasted only through the spontaneous love of liberated persons who chant the holy names with great ecstatic love. This sweetness can be tasted only through the spontaneous love of liberated persons who chant the holy names with ecstatic love. Who wants Vraja Bhakti? How do we get it? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, you cannot get it by karma kand. You cannot get it by fasting and doing tapasharya. You cannot get it through yoga. You cannot get it through jnana. You cannot get it through Vaidhi Bhakti. You cannot get it through japa. 99% of sadhana is japa. Mahaprabhu is saying you cannot get it by Vaidhi Bhakti. You cannot get it by japa. You cannot get it by dhyan meditation.
कर्म तप योग ज्ञान वैधि भक्ति जप ध्यान इहा हैते माधुर्य दुर्लभ। माधुर्य प्रेम, कृष्ण प्रेम, व्रज भक्ति, विच इज आवर एम, यू कैनॉट गेट बाय दीज प्रोसेसेस। केवल ये राग मार्गे भजे कृष्ण अनुरागे तारे कृष्ण माधुर्य सुलभ। Who comes to your mind when you read this sentence? Who comes to your mind? Who is that Krishna Premi? Who is that pure devotee? Who is that liberated devotee who chanted the holy names with ecstatic love? How many of you have seen that video in Tompkins Square Park? The first Harinam Sankirtan in the history of this planet on North America. Who brought Srimad Bhagavatam for the first time in the history of mankind to Paschatya Desh on a Jaladuta ship? Who performed the first Harinam Sankirtan? He was alone chanting, with his eyes closed, intense concentration, pure love in his heart. That love was so pure, my dear friends, that he left Rupa Goswami's Samadhi. He left the beautiful Govardhan Shila of Sanatan Goswami, which have the beautiful footprints of Krishna. He left the beautiful deity of Radha Damodar, which was hand-carved by Rupa Goswami for his beloved nephew and disciple, Srila Jiva Goswami. He left that place where the three acharyas, Srinivas Acharya, Shyamananda Pandit and Narottam Das Thakur, used to meet every day and discuss Bhakti Siddhanta, discuss Krishna Leelamrit, discuss Chaitanya Charitamrit. That Radha Damodar temple, Srila Prabhupada left, boarded the Jaladuta ship at the age of 70, sustained 2 heart attacks, severe seasickness, motion sickness, dizziness, headache, vomiting, no appetite, alone, no servants, no family. He had everything. He gave up because he had that pure love. Because he wanted us to be together on this conference call today and discuss Chaitanya Charitamrita on August 29th, 2018. This would never have happened if Prabhupada would not have come to the Paschatya Desh. The Goloka Duta boarded the Jaladuta. The ambassador of Goloka Vrindavan boarded that ship. He only had his English translation of the first canto of Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam with him. And he had a Bengali copy of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrit printed in Bengali language by His Divine Grace, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Yes. In his Gaudiya Math Brihad Mridanga, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur had printed Chaitanya Charitamrita. Because Chaitanya Charitamrita was very durlabh. With the passage of time, everything was lost. Bhakti Vinod Thakur had to search for years and years
different temples, different places, different towns, different villages to find one authentic copy of Chaitanya Charitamrita. He could not find. After many, many years of desperate prayers and hard labor, knocking on different doors, going to different remote temples, finally, Bhaktivinoda Thakur found one handwritten copy of Chaitanya Charitamrita. Immediately, he took possession and made two copies. The world cannot be deprived of this nectar. Chaitanya Charitamrita has to be printed. And his son, the ray of Vishnu, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, printed Chaitanya Charitamrita. And Prabhupada brought it with him to read during his almost 40-day voyage. It was Srila Prabhupada who brought the words of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to the Western world. And we are sitting in the Western world. And even in India, Prabhupada preached the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu so much. But in his Pranati Mantra, we simply say, Namaste Sarasvate Deve. I offer my respectful obeisance to that person whose Lord, Dev, was Saraswati Thakur, Srila Prabhupada. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, Srila Prabhupada. Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine. Our Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Gauravani Pracharine. He preached the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine. He delivered the Western countries like Europe and America and Africa and westernized countries like Australia and New Zealand. But even India, in India he gave Radha Ras Bihari. In India he gave Temple of Vedic Planetarium, TOVP. Chandrodaya Mandir in Navadvip. He gave temples in Delhi. He gave Krishna Balaram Mandir in Vrindavan. He established so many centers and temples all across India. Then why only Paschatya Desh Tarin? Why not Bhuloka Tarine? Why not Sarva Jagat Tarine? Why Paschatya Desh Tarine? It is minimizing the glory of Srila Prabhupada. But no, it is not minimizing the glory of Srila Prabhupada. By minimizing glorification of Srila Prabhupada, we are increasing the glorification of Srila Prabhupada. How is that? Because in India, Bharat Bhumi, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, the spiritual master of our Srila Prabhupada, he had already preached Gauravani. 64 temples, 64 Gaudiya Mats, printing press, Brihad Mridang, thousands of disciples, yes. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur had already preached in India. So out of his humility, our Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada did not want to take any credit for preaching in India. Although he preached vigorously in India, Radha Ras Vihari, Radha Madhav Ashtasakhi, Krishna Balaram. So much preaching he did in India. But Prabhupada did not want to touch a drop of credit for preaching in India. Because his spiritual master, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, had already preached in India. So he simply accepted Paschatya Deshatarine. Not Sarva Desha Tarine. No. although he went to all the continents inhabited by mankind, but he did not take credit. So by not taking credit, by reducing his glorification is increased. Just see the sweet humility of Prabhupada. Only simply saying, Paschatya Deshatarine. It is this Srila Prabhupada who can give us Vraja Bhakti. The sweetness, this sweetness can be tasted only through the spontaneous love of liberated persons who chant the holy names with great ecstatic love. What is the conclusion, my dear friends? The conclusion is that Vraja Bhakti can be given to us only by a liberated soul. Only by a liberated soul. Not by very, very great devotees who are practicing Vaidhi Bhakti. No. Because Bhagwan, Bhakta and Bhakti do not belong to this material world. We'll repeat. Bhagwan, Bhakta and Bhakti does not belong to this material world. Because material world is a world of bhogis. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhoga vancha kari. Bhoga vancha. We want to enjoy. This is the world of sense gratifiers. Bhagwan, bhakti and bhakta do not belong in this world. Therefore, if we want to get Krishna prem, we can only get it from Krishna premi. Krishna premis are not conditioned souls. They are eternally liberated, nitya siddha devotees who descend from the spiritual world. Only they can give us Krishna prem. Krishna se tomar, Krishna diye paro, tomara shakati yache. Krishna se tomar. They can bind Krishna in the knot of their dhoti and carry Krishna around. Krishna se tomar. Krishna is their property. Sold out. Mahaprabhu said so many times in Chaitanya Charitamrita, I am yours, I am sold out to you. Haridas Thakur, you can sell me in any marketplace. Vasudev Datta, you can sell me in any marketplace. You can give me to anybody. I am yours, I am sold out to you. Only such a Krishna premi can give Raja Prem. That is clearly mentioned here by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We'll go to the next verse. Such ecstatic transactions between Krishna and the gopis are possible only in Vrindavan, which is full of opulences of transcendental love. The form of Krishna is the original source of all transcendental qualities. It is like a mine of gems. The opulences belonging to all the personal expansions of Krishna are to be understood to be bestowed by Krishna. Therefore, Krishna is the original source and shelter of everyone. Anera vaibhava satta Krishna datta bhagavata Krishna sarva amshi sarvashraya. If we are given the credit of doing anything wonderful, first thing we should do is reject that opinion internally. Never ever we should think that we have done anything wonderful. Whether it is preaching, whether it is congregation development, whether it is painting, cooking, kirtan, lecture, deity worship, whatever service it is there, festival management, leadership, whatever service we have done, we should never think I am the doer, or this nice thing has been done by me, this nice offering has been written by me, this nice bhajan has been sung by me, this nice class has been given by me. Krishna is the doer. Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj, he writes, we should never, most important principle in Krishna consciousness is, we should never take credit. We should never ever take credit for anything, because it is natural, my dear friends. As we advance in bhakti, or as we become senior, just chronologically, just by being around, His Holiness Jayadat Maharaj was here. He is such a exemplary Vaishnav, such a source of inspiration. He was asked a question when he was in Atlanta recently. How did you do it? You got initiated in 1968, it is 2018 now, 50 years, more than 50 years. You have been initiated for more than 50 years. More than 50 years ago, you were initiated by Srila Prabhupada. Every single day you have chanted your japa, never missed it. You have been like such a staunch brahmachari, you are an emblem of brahmacharya. Never. Perfect brahmachari. Such an exemplary sannyasi. Such an exemplary leader. Such wonderful services, editor of BBT. How have you done this? What is your realization? What is the secret? And very humbly, His Holiness Jayadat Maharaj said, well, you just be, how old are you now? You are in your 30s, 40s. You just stick around for 50 years, and after 50 years, people will say the same thing about you. Just by being around. So he was teaching us, he was telling us that just by being around, the respect of a senior devotee comes. Oh, you are already initiated. Oh, you have been chanting for you have been in ISKCON for so many years. Naturally, respect comes. But we should never think that we are respectable. But we should be respectful. We should be full of respect for others. Amani na mana dena. But if we think that we have done something, when people compliment us, then glorify us, if we think that, yes, I have done something wonderful, that is it. That is a fall down. Because in this verse, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is clearly saying, whatever wonderful activities you do, that is because of Krishna.
Balam balavatam chaham kamaraga vivarjitam dharma aviruddho bhuteshu kamosmin bharatar shabha.
Balam balavatam chaham. Krishna gives the strength. He is the strength of the strong. Everything that is done is by Krishna's mercy. In the last verse for today,
Shri Lajja Daya Kirti Dhairya Vaisharadi Mati Ei Sabha Krishne Pratishthita Sushila Mridu Vadanya Krishna Samanahi Anya Krishna Kori Jagate Rahita.
How beautiful. Purport by Srila Prabhupada.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur mentions that the qualities of
beauty,
humility, mercy, merit, patience, and expert intelligence are brilliant qualities. And when they are exhibited in the person of Narayan, one should know that they are bestowed upon Narayan by Krishna. Good behavior, mildness, and magnanimity are found only in Krishna. Only Krishna performs welfare activities for the whole world.
Krishna kore jagatera hita.
Everything is coming from Krishna. If people think that we have done something nice, all glories to Guru and Gauranga. No glories to me. It's all because of Krishna. All because of Krishna. That is the meaning and practical application of these beautiful verses. We'll conclude. It is not a coincidence. You see, Chaitanya Charitamrita, we always sing in the other meter. Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Advaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. But today's verses, we can sing in a different meter. And this same meter Srila Prabhupada has used in his Jalalutha diary when he wrote that beautiful Bengali bhajan. Krishna Tava Punya Habe Bhai. Just see the verses that we read today. That same meter Prabhupada has written this bhajan. Shri Lajja Daya Kirti Dhairya Vaisaradi Mati Ei Sabha Krishna Pratishthita. This is the verse. Now see, what Prabhupada writes. Shri Siddhanta Saraswati Sachi Suta Priya Ati Krishna Sevaya Jara Tulanai Sei Se Mohanta Guru Jagater Madhe Uru Krishna Bhakti Deya Thai Thai. My spiritual master Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is very dear to the son of Sachi Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very dear to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And as far as serving Krishna is concerned, there is no tulana. There is no comparison. Krishna sevai jara tulanai. There is no, cannot be compared. And he is such a great guru. Sei se mohanta guru jagater madhe uru. Famous all over the world. Because he can give Krishna bhakti deya thai thai. He can give Krishna bhakti left, right and center. Prabhupada is giving all credit. And then, because he is reading Chaitanya Charitamrita on that Jaladutta and he is writing,
Aji je subidahala tomara smarana bhela boro asha dakilam tai ami tomar nitya das tai koriye to ash tumi bina anya gati nai.
Prabhupada is crying out. He is nauseated. He is vomiting. He is throwing up. He has no appetite. His chest is hurting. He is having heart attack. He is feeling dizzy. He is feeling miserable. But in the midst of all these miserable symptoms,
Tattenu kampam susamikshamano Bhunjana evatma kritam vipakam Ridavakvapurbhir vidadhan namaste Jivetya mukti padesadaya bhak.
He is offering his love and gratitude to Krishna.
Ami tomar nitya das.
Oh my Krishna, I am your eternal servant.
Tai kori eto ash.
And I have only one desire, one request, one hope, one petition at your lotus feet, that
Tumi bina anya gati nai.
Tumi bina anya gati nai. I don't have any other refuge, any other shelter other than you. This is ananya bhakti. This is a Krishna Premi who has descended from the spiritual world.
Tumi mora chira sathi bhuliya mayar lathi kai yache janma janmantare aji puna eshu joga jadi hoy joga joga tabe pari tunhe mili bare tomar milane bhai आभार से सुख पाई गोचारणे घुरी दिना भोर। कत बने छुटी छुटी बने खाई लुटा लुटी सेई दिन कबे हबे मोर।
ओ माय डियर कृष्णा, तुमी मोर चिर साथी, यू आर माय इटर्नल असोसिएट। And then Prabhupada is taking our position, position of a conditioned soul, and he says, Bhuliya Mayar Lathi. I forgot you, and I got the kicks of Maya. Prabhuji and Mataji, even today, how horribly we are kicked by Maya. How horribly. How quickly we fall prey to temptations. How inconsistent we are in our sadhana. How inconsistent we are with the regulative principles, gross and subtle. That means we are being kicked by Maya. Mayar Lathi. Janma Janmantare. Birth after birth, not just this lifetime, birth after birth. But when we get the association of pure devotees, Nitya Siddha devotees, Krishna Premi devotees like Srila Prabhupada, he is our only hope, my dear friends. Prabhupada is our only hope. We should cling on to his institution. We should cling on to his Vani. We should cling on to his books. Go deep and serve each other and strengthen ISKCON. That way Prabhupada will shower more and more mercy on us. Tomara milane bhai, abar se sukha pai. And when we are reunited with you, then we'll experience real happiness. Gocharane ghuri dina bhor. All day long, I will do gocharan lila with you, my dear Kanha. Let us go to the forest and take care of our cows. Let's feed the cows. Just see Krishna. In this material world, we are running after frothing, foaming at our mouths, laboring hard for roti. Just to earn our livelihood, we are working hard. To fill our mouths and stomach, we are working hard. But in the spiritual world, Krishna is feeding the cows all day. Gocharan Leela. Every day. No holiday, no vacation, no off day. Happily. Not happily. Ecstatically. Our beloved Krishna with his associates, not alone, with his innumerable friends, he takes his innumerable cows and feeds them grass. Gocharan. Feeds them. Krishna is feeding his devotees all day long. Giving Vipralamba to the gopis who are waiting in the village of Uraja. When will our Gopinath come back? And then he comes and there is union. And there is union. आजी पुना से सुजोग जड़ी होए जोगा जोगा तबे पारी तुम्हें मिली बारे। कट बने छूटा छूटी बने हाई लूटा लूटी से दिन कबे हबे मोर। दिस इज कॉल्ड ट्रांसेंडिंग द बॉडी। व्हेन यू आर हैविंग हार्ट अटैक, when you are having motion sickness, seasickness, nausea, vomiting, loss of appetite, headache, dizziness, you are all alone, how can you write these ecstatic, poetic bhajans? How? It is because Prabhupada is not from this world. He is from the spiritual world. And he is our only hope. These were some of the thoughts I wanted to share with all of you. Thank you very much for your patient listening. जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय, श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत की जय, श्रील कृष्णदास कविराज गोस्वामी महाराज की जय, निताई गौर प्रेमानंदी हरि हरि बोल, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू ऑल ऑफ यू, हरे कृष्णा।
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, thank you very much for the beautiful class. I have one question, can I ask?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Prabhuji, like we discussed that Krishna is the doer, should not take credit. So, I was confused in reference to suppose some devotee does something good for us. And if we think that Krishna is the doer, that mentality then, and we don't give feedback or good appreciation to the other devotees, good for us, it becomes little rude. So how do we understand this concept in with respect to the relationship on devotees and or non-devotees when they do something good for us?
Hare Krishna. Spiritual maturity means to see Krishna along with Krishna's energies. If we only appreciate Krishna, that is the definition of Kanishtha Adhikari, neophyte devotee. But a mature devotee is one who gives up the Kanishtha mentality of only giving credit to Krishna and sees Krishna along with his energies. Krishna is never without his energies. Namami Bhakta Shaktikam. In the Panchatattva Mantra. So we have to give credit to the devotees also. We understand that the devotees are getting mercy. Devotees are getting empowerment from Krishna. But devotees are Krishna's instruments. We have to respect, appreciate, encourage, glorify Krishna's instruments also. Just like if we want to make friendship with a very great person, but we neglect the children of that great person, then the great person will not be pleased. But if we are nice to the great person and we are nice to the children also, then the great person will be pleased. So Krishna is pleased when we give credit to his devotees also, who are acting on behalf of Krishna. Krishna and his energies. Bhakta Rupa Swarukapam, Bhaktavataram Bhaktakam, Namami Bhakta Shaktikam. All his Shaktis, we have to give credit to them also. When we glorify devotees, whether they are devotees or non-devotees, when they have done something good and we glorify them, we should glorify them in a way that will encourage them, but at the same time, not make them egoistic. So we can glorify them by saying, such a nice service you have done. Prabhu, Krishna is really empowering you. May Krishna empower you more and more. May Krishna bless you more and more. Means what? What you have just done is by the blessings of Krishna. So we have to be thoughtful when we give words of appreciation and praise. But we must appreciate Krishna along with his devotees. It is said that if we love Krishna, the devotees will love us. And if we love the devotees, Krishna will love us. So therefore we should never be miserly in praising others. At the same time we should be realistic, factual in our praise, and we should praise in such a way that the connection with Krishna is easily visible in our words of praise. When we bless somebody, Krishna Irmati Rastu. May you always be Krishna conscious. If somebody has done something nice, what a nice work you have done in Krishna's service. May Krishna empower you more. May Krishna bless you more. We are praying for that person like that. So always keep Krishna in the center. So does that help, Gaur Kesha Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhu. So basically, you mean Krishna and his energies are the doer. So energies also include Krishna's devotee. So we should understand in that way. Okay.
Yes, the devotees are cooperating with Krishna. Therefore, nimitta matra bhava savya sachin. Krishna is making them his instruments and working through them. That's why they are glorious, and we should offer them all respects. All respects. We are always dependent on the mercy of Hari, Guru, and Vaishnavas. Not just Hari, but Hari, Guru, and Vaishnavas. In spiritual world, if you look at Krishna's Leela, whether it is Ras Leela, whether it is Gocharan Leela, whether it is Damodar Leela, any Leela, Krishna never does it with one devotee. Krishna always does it with a group, a big group of devotees. Ras Leela with innumerable gopis. Damodar Leela, innumerable monkeys. Gocharan Leela, innumerable cows. So it is always a sankirtan in spiritual life. It is never one person. In spiritual life means sankirtan. We have to work together. That is why Srila Prabhupada established Society of Devotees, International Society for Krishna Consciousness. So that before we go to the spiritual world, we learn how to work together as a team, how to cooperate, how to appreciate, how to glorify each other. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Dhanat Pranam. All glories to Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. It's a very, very inspiring class to go. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mataji. May I know your name, please?
Anjana Gopi. Anjana Gopika Mataji. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna, Anjana Gopika Mataji. My obeisances to you. Thank you. All glories to Srila Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna, Adi Kajaradas Prabhu, Janvat Pranam to you all, Seva. Prabhuji, such a nectarian class. Thank you very much for your assistance, as usual, Prabhuji. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Srila Guru Dev ki.
Thank you very much, Vrinda Gopika Mataji. All glories to Srila Prabhupada.
Yeah, Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Janvat Pranam, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. Thank you very much, Prabhuji, for a very, very wonderful class. And Prabhuji, I seek your permission to say something what you and Gaur Kesha Prabhu just discussed.
Yes, Madhuri, please go ahead. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, so Prabhuji, I feel that certainly whatever Krishna is doing with devotees or through devotees, that is good for all the devotees. But I feel that better communication should also be there. Means like, although everyone is an instrument of Krishna, but sometimes because of our conditioning, it's very difficult for us to take up certain situation because of our conditioning only. So I feel that if we have better communication with the devotees and with our seniors, so that would also help us. What do you say about it?
Yes, Ishwar Kumar Mataji. That is, thank you for bringing up that point. Communication is vital. Without communication, how can you make your feelings known, make your appreciation known, or make your concerns known to others? So
yeah,
communication
correct.
Is very important.
Yeah, because we feel very weak unless we speak. We feel very weak within our heart and we speculate over so many things, which is not like true. So it's better to communicate than to tolerate as it is Krishna's verdict only. I mean, it's like we should try to tolerate, but at least we should have a talk first. Then we should tolerate. Thank you very much, Prabhuji.
I agree. Yeah. Thank you for bringing up that point.
Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Hi, Krishna Prabhu. Thank you for class. I have a few questions, actually. Let me start by just following up on your answer to one of the questions just a while ago, where you said that Krishna always has his leaders in big groups, you know, of devotees. So I was wondering if you would agree that the exception is when he is having his private times with Radharani.
Yes, but Radharani is not a jivatma like us.
Mm-hmm,
Radharani
right.
is non-different from Krishna. So,
yeah.
But with jivatmas, it is always sankirtan. Always
okay. Okay. See, I didn't realize that you were referring only to jivatmas in that case, you know.
Sorry, Madhari, say that again.
I did not realize that you were referring only to jivatmas when you made that statement.
Yes, Madhari, for us, for devotees, for jivatmas, it is always, you know, we serve Krishna in the association of Guru and Vaishnavas.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as Srimati Radharani is concerned, Srimati Radharani is non-different from Krishna.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wonder, I mean, I wonder if there was any, if there was ever any reason given for why he deals with jivatmas only in large groups.
A father feels great happiness when his children are blissful together. So similarly, we are all Krishna's children, and where all the devotees come together, we can serve Krishna better. Ekakiyamar nahi payabala. Alone we cannot do it, but together we can do so many wonderful things, whether it is building the bridge across the Indian Ocean to Lanka, whatever service it is, when we work together, we can do much more, much better. And seeing us together, seeing us cooperating, gives the greatest pleasure to our eternal Father, Sri Krishna.
Mm. Okay. Thank you. Also, another question I had was, I'm referring to when you said that you were describing the nature of Gopi Bhav and, you know, prema, you know. And you were giving the example that the gopis are, you know, they have no problem at all going to hell for the sake of Krishna's pleasure. And you said, not only do they not have a problem, they're eager to go to hell. But I was wondering if what you really meant was that it's not so much that they're eager to go to hell, but they're just so eager to please Krishna that they don't care if it means going to hell. Or did you literally mean that they're eager to go to hell?
What I meant, Gaurangi Mataji, is that it is one thing to say that, all right, take this dust, I am willing to go to hell for Krishna's sake. But that is not what the gopis did. They gave Narad Muni the dust and they said, you go first, go. Give this dust to Krishna immediately. And Narad Muni said, but hey, don't you know what is going to happen to you if you put dust from your feet on Krishna's head? We'll explain to you later, you first go and give. So Narad Muni pretends to go and give the dust and then comes back and then they explain. They give their purport. That, you know, what is the harm? If Krishna is going to feel relief from his headache, we don't have any problem going to hell. In fact, if that is going to give him relief from the headache, we want to go to hell. We want to do it. That's all we want to do. That's the only thing we want to do. So that is eagerness. Eagerness to serve, no matter what the consequences are.
Mm-hmm. Okay. One last thing is refers to Krishna Das Kaviraj's sentiment that, you know, he feels like worm in a stool. So I'm just asking for clarification of my own understanding that he is able to say this only because by comparison only of, you know, his heart to the magnanimity of Krishna's heart, there is such a disparity that he is perceiving that by comparison he feels like worm and stool. So worm and stool means that he has such a depth of appreciation of the greatness of Krishna's heart that by comparison his own heart seems puny. So is that correct interpretation of Krishnadas?
So Mataji, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami's extreme humility has many aspects to it. As far as mm-hmm. the cause of that the source of that humility is concerned. And we mm-hmm. cannot understand it. We cannot understand it, but there are some aspects that we can reflect upon, we can think about. One is what you mentioned, that in comparison to what Krishna has given us, he feels incapable of reciprocating in proportion. So mm-hmm. he feels humbled. But then if you see, he says that I am more sinful than Jagai and Madai. How can you reconcile that? Or I am lower than a worm in the stool. How do you reconcile that? So there are several things that we, first of all is we cannot understand the humility of such great souls, because this humility is not something that you cultivate. This humility is bestowed upon you. This humility is given by Krishna.
Mm-hmm.
Another aspect is, a worm in the stool is a worm in the stool. People don't even look twice at the worm in the stool. But Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Maharaj, everybody is coming and offering respects. The worm in the stool is also Jivatma. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami also Jivatma. But look at me, I'm such a rascal, I'm accepting respect from all these people. Whereas the worm in the stool is taking such a humble position, therefore the worm in the stool is greater than me, humbler than me, more exalted than me. Look at me, I'm sitting on the Vyasa and speaking Chaitanya Charitamrita. That is the mind, that is the heart of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. Why is he more sinful than Jagai and Madhai? Because Jagai and Madhai were Jagai and Madhai. At least they were saying that, okay, we are drunkards, we are arsonists, we are sinful people, we intoxicate, you know, we break all rules. They were at least honest. But look at me. I am pretending to be a Paramahamsa devotee. People are worshipping me as Paramahamsa devotees. They are giving me so much respect. And look at me. I am not even able to reciprocate with my Krishna. What a hypocrite I am. At least Jagai Madai are not hypocrites. Therefore, they are better than me. I am more sinful than them. Who can understand, Matari? Who can understand what is going on in the heart of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami? We can just reflect on it and wonder how exalted they are.
mm-hmm.
I hope that helps, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. I think it is very late now. It is 12:45 p.m. So we will end the class here. I am very, very grateful to all of you for giving me this opportunity to serve you on this conference call. Vansha Kalpataru Bhyasa.